हेलो पार्टिसिपेंट्स, वेलकम टू 1 वीक फैकल्टी डेवलपमेंट प्रोग्राम ऑन मॉडर्न टीचिंग इवैल्यूएशन एंड रिसर्च मेथड्स ऑर्गेनाइज्ड बाय विनायकराव पाटिल महाविद्यालय वैजापुर. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई थैंक द ऑर्गेनाइजर्स ऑफ दिस FDP एंड प्रिंसिपल ऑफ द विनायकराव पाटिल महाविद्यालय वैजापुर फॉर गिविंग मी द अपॉर्चुनिटी टू शेयर माई नॉलेज. I am Dr. Ganesh Phad from Ketejam College, Nasik. I am working as assistant professor in Department of Statistics of Ketejam College, Nasik. Today, we will going to see the data analysis using R software. R is a free and open source software. So how to analyze data using R software? So R software for data analysis. R software is an alternative for SPSS. SPSS means statistical package for social sciences, which is paid software. Minitab is another paid software. SAS, CSTAT, all these are paid softwares, but R is free. So R software is developed by Ross Eka and Robert Gentleman from New Zealand in 1996. R is free and open source software that is capable of handling mathematical and statistical manipulations. It has its own programming language as well as built-in functions to perform any specialized task. Now, how to install R software? To install R software, go to this link www.r-project.org. So I am going on this link and follow these instructions. So go to Google. Now type here www.r-project.org. Click on enter. Now here we have to click on download R. So click on download R. Here some CRAN mirrors are given. Select any one. You can select this one from Australia. You can select any one, but I am going to select this one. So click on this. Now here there are three option comes to download R software. Download R for Linux, for Mac system and for Windows. If you have Windows, then click on download R for Windows. Now after clicking on this download R for Windows, it asks whether you are installing this software first time. So click on here, install R for the first time. Click on this. Click on here, download R 4.0 for Windows. This is the latest version, R 4.0.0. So click on this. So it starts downloading. Now after download completes, it takes some time. After download completes, go to downloads. Now here .exe file comes. So R 4.0.0/win. So to install this software, double click on this and follow the instructions. So after clicking on next and follow some instructions, there is one option comes, which is whether you have to create a desktop shortcut. Check the box, create a desktop shortcut and follow the instructions, then you can install this R software. After installing this R software properly, the desktop shortcuts created here on desktop, which is R4.0.0. If you click on double click on this, then it opens this R software. So this is R version 4.0.0 and this is command prompt. This greater than sign means the command prompt. We have to type command here. This is not like other softwares. We have to type commands here. So we will go to our presentation. So to install R software, follow these instructions. I had already shown you how to install R software. Now this advantages of this R software. R is not proprietary product. It is not copyrighted and therefore it is open to everybody to modify, upgrade or improve in any way one can think of. R is an free and open source. We can run R anywhere and at any time. R is the most comprehensive statistical analysis package, as new technology and ideas often appears first in R because it is an open source and anyone can upgrade and modify it. R is compatible with Microsoft, Windows, Linux and Mac system. In R, anyone is welcome to provide bug fixes, code enhancement and new packages. So anyone can modify it or upgrade it. So these are some advantages of R software. Why R is FOSS? FOSS means free and open source software. The developers of R believe that if it is free and open source, then better contribution will come from those who may not be a member of the development team of R software. That's why they put R in a free and open source software. Why named R? The best answer is both the developers' name starts with R. Ross and Robert. Now, if you open, I had already shown, the R software looks like this. This is command prompt. You have to type command here. Now manual data entry in R. Suppose we want to enter some data in this software, R software, to do some analysis. To enter data manually, the syntax is my data. My data means you have to give name for this data. C means use this combine function. And type the values of your data separated by comma. So, and to see the entire data, whatever name you had given, type that name, then you can see that data. We will go for example, then you will understand betterly. So example, the height in centimeter of 15 students in Vinayakrao Patil Mahavidyalay, Vaizapur are given below. These are height of 15 students from this Vinayakrao Patil Mahavidyalay, Vaizapur. And we have to enter this data in R. Suppose we want to find some mean of this height or median of this height. We want to do some analysis on this height. So to type this data in R software, use this command. Give name height. You can give any name. So here H is capital. This is case sensitive. So if H is capital here, then you have to type H is capital here also. So height is equal to combine function and type these values separated by comma. So to save time, I will copy this. Consider this. I am typing in R software. So I will go to R software. Now type here whatever you have to enter. I have to enter height of 15 students. So consider this I had typed. To save time, I had copied and pasted, but consider this I had typed this height is equal to C and all these values. So to see this data which is saved in this height, H-E-I-G-S-T, height. So this 15 values are entered in this height variable. So this one represents one first row. It contains 15 values. So we'll go to our presentation. Now, many a times we have our data in Excel file. We have to copy that data and paste in any software. So suppose we have a data in Excel file, already typed data in Excel file. To copy that data from Excel file and to paste in that data in your R software, the command is my data is equal to read.table. File is equal to double inverted commas clipboard and header equal to T. T stands for true. Means if you have your data having headings, suppose height of students are given and you are selecting that header also means height also, then here it is true. And if you are not selecting that height name, then here header is false. So to see your data, whatever name you had given, type that name. We'll go to example. Suppose height of 15 students from this college is given. And we had already this data in suppose Excel. So I will share the Excel file. Suppose this is height of this 15 students I had already typed. And we want to enter this data in SPSS, which is already typed data in Excel. So select this. If you are selecting this first row also, then header is true. If you are not selecting this, then your header is false. So I am selecting from this. Select your data. Copy this data. Now, come to our software. Type here that command, data is equal to read dot table, then file is equal to clipboard because we had copied this data on clipboard. So file is equal to clipboard comma header. We are selected headings, so header is equal to T stands for true. Now that data of height of 15 students comes in this data variable. So data, if you type this data name data here, then the height of 15 students comes in this R software. So like this, you can type manually your data, or if you had already typed data, then you can use this command to enter type data in Excel to import you can type data manually, or if you had already typed data in Excel, then to import that data from Excel to our software, you can type this command, data equal to read dot table, file is equal to in double inverted comma clipboard, and header is true or false. So we'll go to our presentation. Now to import Excel file into R, means suppose you don't want to copy this on clipboard, you directly want to import that Excel file in R. So command is, first we have to save as the Excel file in .csv format. .csv means comma delimited format. Then use this command, use following syntax to import file in R. So my data here, read.csv and file.choose, header is equal to true. And to see this data, type whatever name you had given here, my data. So we will go to example. Suppose same example, height of 15 students from this Vinayakrao Patil Mahavidyalaya Vaijapur are given, and we have, suppose we had saved this file in .csv format. How to save, I will show you. This is your Excel file. To save as this into .csv format, click on file, click here on save as. Here .csv format, to save as this into .csv format, click here and click on save, click on OK. Now this file is saved in .csv format. So This file is saved, same file, but the extension is comma separated value file. So same file saved, the name of file is height. So to enter this into a R software, I will share R software window. Type the command data equal to read.csv. Data is equal to read.csv file dot choose. Comma header, because we had given headings to that file, so header is equal to true. Now by using this file dot choose command, you can choose where your file is saved. So if you enter, then you have to choose the wherever your file is saved. So my file is saved on this folder, so I am going in that folder. So this is .csv file. Now if you type this whatever name you had given, I had given data name, so if you type this, then you will get that Excel file into this R software. So this is one another way to import your data of Excel file in R software. We will go to our presentation. Now one another way to import your file in your Excel file in R software. Here only you have to save as this file in .txt format, tab delimited text file, same procedure, but here you have to save this file, save as .txt format, and use this command. Here my data is equal to read.table. Here it is not read.csv, here read.table file.choose and header is equal to true. By using this command, you can import your Excel file data into R software. So suppose the same example, and if we had saved this file in .txt format, use this command, then your data will came in R software. So I will not going to do this. You have to do this as assignment. Now manual data entry in R if more than one variables are given, means suppose height of students are given and weight of students are given, and I want to enter this data into R software. So you can enter this data, height is equal to, by using this combined function, enter their heights, and weight, by using this combined function, enter their weights. And to join this data, so my data is equal to, use this command, data dot frame, whatever name you had given, height comma weight. So like this you can enter your data when more than one variables are given. We will go to example. Suppose the weight, height and weight of 15 students from this Vinayakrao Patil Mahavidyalaya Vaizapur are given below, and we have to enter this data into R software. So before we had seen how to enter this data manually. So height, enter this data of height in this, by using combined function, in this height variable. Enter weight of this 15 students in this weight variable, and then to make table of this, use this command, data dot frame height comma weight. So to save time, I will copy this and go to our software. Now here, right click and use paste commands only. So in height variable, height of 15 students games, and in weight variable, weight of 15 students games. Now to join this or to make a table of this one, use command data is equal to, I am giving data name for this file, and by using data dot frame height, H-E-I-G-H-T, height and weight. Now if you type this data here, then height and weight of this 15 students comes in one file in table format. So like this, you can enter data of more than one variable. So we'll go to our presentation. This is same output I have copied and pasted here. Now descriptive statistics by using R. Means suppose you want to find mean, median, suppose variance, standard deviation by using this R. First quartile, third quartile. The syntax is only summary of whatever name you had given to your file. So summary of my data. Suppose I had given this file name as data, then summary of data. To obtain variance and standard deviation, the syntax are VAR of, suppose your data, you had given file name as data and your variable name is, suppose in data your height and weight, these are two variables are there. So data dollar sign and then height means this gives variance of the height column. And suppose you want to find variance of weight column, then here VAR of data dollar weight. So this will find variance of your weight column. Similarly, standard to find standard deviation, use this SD. So we'll go to example. Suppose same example, the height of 15 students are given and we want to find mean, median, variance and standard deviation. So enter this data in R software by using combine function. Or if you have data in Excel file, then you can copy this data and use this command to import that data into R software. So I have already this data in Excel, so I will copy this. Control C, go to R. Here, type the command data is equal to read dot table file is equal to clipboard comma header is equal to true. So this data comes in R software. Now to find mean, median, first quartile, third quartile, the command is summary of this data file. If you type this summary of this data, then this will give minimum value is 150, first quartile is 155.5, median is 160, mean is 161.9, third quartile is 168, and maximum value is 175. So by using this single command, you can find this mean, median, maximum, minimum, first quartile, third quartile. To find variance, use VAR of this height. VAR of this data file, and in that data file, dollar sign height column. So type this command VAR data dollar height, then this will give variance, which is 61.49524. To find standard deviation, SD of data dollar height. So this will give standard deviation of this data. Standard deviation is just square root of this variance. So 7.84189, this is your standard deviation. So we'll go to our presentation. So summary of this data, this will give this many things. And to find variance, use this command VAR data dollar height. In that data file, find variance of this column, height column. Similarly, to find standard deviation, use this command. Now, we will going to move correlation. Before this, remember this line. Or note down this line: if p value, significant value, is less than 0.05, then reject H naught, otherwise accept H naught. Any software gives this p value, or some software gives or say this as a significant value. If your p value is less than this, your level of significance, usually we are considering 5%. So if your p value is less than 0.05, then reject H0. Otherwise, accept H0. Now this H0 means null hypothesis. And there is another hypothesis which is called alternative hypothesis. So we are testing H0 versus H1. So move to correlation. The height and weight of 15 students from this college are given. And we want to find correlation coefficient, which is called Carl Pearson's correlation coefficient, which is usually denoted by small r. And we have to check whether it is significant. Significant means whether it is considerable or not. So to find correlation coefficient between this height and weight of these 15 students, now this correlation coefficient always lies between -1 to 1. If your correlation coefficient r is a -1, then you can say there is a perfect negative correlation between these two variables. If your correlation coefficient r is +1, then you can say there is a perfect negative correlation between these two variables. Now this correlation is a quantitative measure between the relationship between two variables. Now if your r is 0, then you can say there is no correlation. If your r is, suppose mod r is greater than 0.8, then you can say there is a considerable correlation between these two variables. And if it is less than 0.3, then you can say there is correlation between these two variables is not considerable or not significant. So we will type. We will type this height data in this height variable by using combine function, this weight data in weight variable by using this combine function. And to find correlation, the simple command is COR between height comma weight. COR of height comma weight. So to save time, I will copy this data entry commands. We will go to our software, but consider this Consider this as I am typing this command. So okay, click here, paste commands only. Now this 15 values came in this height variable, and this 15 values of weight are entered in this weight variable. Now to find correlation, simply use COR of height comma weight. COR of height comma weight. Now the correlation between these two variables is 0.13306. So we will move to our presentation. Same output I had pasted here, 0.133068. The correlation between height and weight is this one. Now, whether this is significant or not, to test whether this correlation is significant or not, the command is core.test height comma weight and method equal to Pearson. Means there are other correlations also. There is a Spearman's rank correlation coefficient. So here our method is not Spearman's, here our method is Pearson's correlation coefficient. So to test whether this is significant or not, command is like this. Now in this case, your H0 is correlation is not significant. Remember, your H0 is the correlation coefficient is not significant, versus H1 is correlation coefficient is significant. Significant means considerable. Now, whether this 0.133068 is considerable, by looking at this, we can say this is not considerable. But to test this one, whether this is considerable or not, the command is this one, core.test. So to save time, I will copy this and go to R software. So here, if we type this command and enter, then this will give you this p value. Look at this p value. Always look at this p value to accept or reject H0. I had already told you that if your p value is less than 0.05, then reject H0, otherwise accept H0. In this case, your p value is 0.6364. Now, whether this p value is less than 0.05? No, this p value is greater than 0.05. So we have to accept H0. What is your H0? H0 is the correlation coefficient is not significant. So here p value is 0.6364 and this is not less than 0.05, so we are not rejecting H0, means we are accepting H0, and H0 is the correlation coefficient is not significant. So last conclusion is the correlation coefficient between height and weight is 0.133068 and is not significant, because there is very low correlation between these two variables, height and weight, 0.133068. If correlation is not significant, then don't go for regression analysis. Remember one thing. If your data is an Excel file of height and weight, then you know how to import this data from Excel to R software. You can use this command read.table file. Clipboard and header is true. So after entering this data, if you want to find correlation, then don't type COR height comma weight, because this data is entered in this data variable, and in that data variable there are two columns, height and weight. You want to find the correlation between these two columns, which is entered in data file height and weight. So use this command COR data dollar height and comma data dollar weight, means find correlation between this data file height column and from this data file weight column. So if your data is in Excel file, how to find correlation? Now suppose there are height of 10 fathers and their sons are given in inches and want to find correlation between x and y. So first enter height of father in, suppose give file name is x. In x enter height of father by using combined function, and in y enter height of their sons by using combined function. To find correlation, just type command cor of x comma y, then you will get correlation. So same I had explained here. So correlation between this x comma y is 0.6368208. So I will show this in R. To save time, I copy and paste here. So right click and paste commands only. So this 15 values entered in this x variable, height of father and height of sons, these 15 values entered in this y variable. To find correlation between these two, so I type command cor of x comma y. So this correlation is 0.6368208. Now whether this correlation is significant or not, the command is cor dot test x comma y comma method is equal to in double inverted comma Pearson. So to see whether this correlation is significant or not, look at this p value. We are looking at this p value means we have h naught and h1. H naught is the correlation is not significant, and h1 is the correlation is significant. So this p value is less than 0.05, which is 0.0477, which is less than 0.05, means we are rejecting h naught. Rejecting h naught means accepting h1, and h1 is the correlation is significant. So last conclusion is the correlation between these two values is 0.6368208, and which is significant. Significant means considerable. So this is your last conclusion. The correlation between this height and weight is 0.63682 and is significant. If this correlation is significant, then only move to regression analysis. So to find regression line of y on x, y means your height of son and x means your height of father. You want to find regression line y equal to a plus bx, means you want to find a and b, these constants. So by using this equation, you can find height of any son whose height of father is known. So to fit a regression line, the only command is, if your data is typed in this x and y, then command is LM. LM stands for linear model. Y tilde x. This tilde is given in keyboard below the escape command. So we'll see this in R. So go to R software. Already we had typed this data x and y. So we want to find regression line of y on x. So LM of y tilde x, only this command. So this will give the intercept coefficients, which is intercept and x coefficient. So the line will be like this: y is equal to 35.4786 plus 0.4821 x. Y means your height of son and x means your height of father. So your regression line will be like this: height of son is equal to 35.4786 plus 0.4821 into height of father. So this is your regression line. By using this equation, you can find height of any son whose height of father is known. So this is regression line of y on x. Suppose you want to find regression line of x on y, then type the command is lm x tilde y. Then you will get a regression line of x on y. Now we will move to graphical representation of data. How to represent data by graphically using this R software? R offers a remarkable variety of graphics. Each graphical function has a large number of options, making the production of graphics very flexible. Now these are some functions and use of this function. Now this plot function is used for scatter plot. This hist function is used to draw histogram. Box plot function is used to draw box and whisker plot. And bar plot, this function is used to draw bar plot, bar diagram. So these are some extra arguments given in this graphical representation. So this main is give to title to this graph. Xlab is used to give label to x axis. Ylab, this command is used to give label to y axis. Xlim, so this is for specifying x limits. Ylim, this is for specifying y limits. Now this type means type of plot. We will see all this while we were drawing the graphs. So these are some arguments, extra arguments to look graph beautifully. Now this color col is equal to, this is used to give color to that graph. Now we will go to example. Let x is equal to 0, 1, 2 up to 5. This is given and draw a plot of x square. Means we have to take x on x axis and x square on y axis. So to type this data, this is data in sequence 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So in R, there is a command which is x is equal to SEQ from sequence from 0 to 5 and their difference is 1. By is equal to 1 means their difference is 1. You can type this data like this also, or you can type this data by using combined function also. X is equal to C 0, 1, 2 up to 5. So go to R. X is equal to, use this command SCQ, sequence from 0 to 5, comma, by means difference between this 0 to 5 is 1. So this will give sequence from 0 to 5 whose difference is 1. If you type this x, then it will give 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now in y, save this x square, x raised to 2, and use this command plot of x comma y. So if you enter, then this will give plot of this x comma y. Means if value of x is 0, the value of its x square is also 0. Value of x is 1, then their value of x square is also 1. Value of x is 2, then their value of x square is 4. Like this graph is given. So we will move to our presentation. Same graph I had copied and pasted here. Now if you want line in each point and title of the graph, then use the following command. So same, you can type this data like this also, no? X is equal to 0 double dot 5 and y equal to x square. use this plot command, plot x comma y, to plot this graph. These are some extra arguments to look graph beautiful. So O stands for lines through points. So this is type. Type means P for points, only points, L for lines, and O for lines through points. So we had given here O, so this means lines through points. So PCH is equal to 1. What is meant by this PCH? PCH is the style of the point. There are so many styles. Between 0 to 20, there are so many styles. So to give style to that point, this PCH is used. If you type PCH is equal to 1 to, you can type PCH is equal to 1 to 20, 0 to 20. So, and LTY is for the style of the lines plotted. Means if you want dotted line, straight line, so the LTY stands for style of line. And X-lab means to give, suppose, label to x-axis, which is x, and y-lab is x square. And main means to give title to this plot, which is line plot. So I will going to copy this command and we will go to R. So right click here, paste commands only. So here these are straight lines given and points are given in round. Now suppose we will change these values. PCH is equal to, now in R, to go to previous command, just click on this upper arrow and I want to change here. PCH is equal to suppose 2, LTY is suppose 4. Now you can see the changes in this graph. So PCH 2 means this triangle and LTY 4 means this dotted line. So like this you can change this PCH and LTY. So we will move to our presentation. Next graph is box plot. A simple way of representing statistical data on a plot is in which a rectangle is drawn to represent the second and third quartile, usually with a horizontal line. This is second. First, this is first quartile, this is second quartile, means median, this is third quartile. The lower and upper quartiles are shown as horizontal lines either side of the rectangle. These are lower quartile, this is upper quartile. Now this is minimum value, this is maximum value, these are outliers. This is interquartile range. Now by looking at this box plot, we can show see whether your data is symmetric or not. If your median line is middle of this and this spread of this data on the both sides is same, then you can say your data will be normal. Data follows normality. So same example of height of 15 students from this college, and we want to find box plot. So enter this data. In R software by using this combine function and use this command box plot of height comma, suppose I want to give title to this as box plot and color to this box plot is gray. So copy this to save time. Go to R. Paste commands only. Now this will give box plot. Now if I change color here, if I change color, suppose red, then this will give box plot like this. Now you can copy this graph and paste wherever you want by clicking, right click on this and copies as copy as bitmap, then you can paste anywhere this graph. So we will move to our presentation. So this is box plot. Now suppose we want here, what is the minimum value, what is the maximum value, what is first quartile, second quartile, third quartile, all these values on this plot. Then the command is this one, text y is equal to box plot dot stats. So use this command to give this values on this graph. So I'm copying this and pasting in this R software. So now you can see these values came here. Minimum value is 150, maximum value is 175, first quartile is 155.5, so second quartile means median is 160, and third quartile is 168. Now by looking at this graph, we can see the data is not normal, because this median is not a middle of this first and second quartile. So this data does not follow normality or does not follow symmetry. So we will move to our presentation. Now bar chart is used to show frequencies of different categories of a categorical variable in the given data. Suppose annual production in metric ton of a certain company is given below, and here an annual production in metric ton is given, and we want to draw bar chart for this one. Now to draw bar chart, first enter this year values in by using combined function or by using this double dot, because it is in sequence 2011 to 2017, and this production values in this prod variable. So enter this data, then use this command bar plot of this production. Now suppose we want to give title to this chart is bar chart. X label is year, Y label is annual production, and this names means, suppose want to give years to this X axis. So 2011, 2012, like this. So use these commands. So I'm copying this. Copying means actually I am typing this in R software. So paste commands only. So this gives you bar chart. So this is your bar chart. This is because of your main function. This is your Y label. This is your X label. This is your X label. This is because of your Y label arguments. Simply you can give command bar plot of production. This also gives you bar plot, but this will not give you the title of your chart. What is on your x-axis? What is on your y-axis? So to looks graph beautiful, we have to give this extra arguments. So now we will move to our presentation. Now we will move to subdivided bar chart. Sometimes it is necessary to show breakup of one variable into several components. This is the data given of income group wise diet type. Now there are six vegetarian peoples from high middle class, high income group, and 17 mixed diet type peoples from high income group. There are 14 vegetarian peoples from low income group. Like this data is given, we want to show this data by using subdivided bar chart. Subdivided bar chart means like this. Means in on x-axis, the income groups are given, and on y-axis, number of persons. And this vegetarian peoples are shown by some color, and mixed peoples are shown by some color. So to enter this data in our software, enter this data of vegetarian peoples by using combined function in veg variable, and enter this mixed diet type peoples data in mixed variable by using combined function. So to make a table of this data, use this d equal to data dot frame veg comma mix. So I will show this in R. So type these commands in R, and if you see, you can see this data in R. But I want to give row names to this data. So to give row names to this data, suppose this is high middle class, this is middle, and this is low. So to give row names, type this command row names of D is equal to combined function high, middle, and low. And now if you type this D, then you can see this row name changes. To draw a bar plot, the command is bar plot of table of this D. Now color. Suppose one to give for vegetarian peoples gray color and for mixed peoples white color. This main is used to give title to this chart, subdivided chart. X lab means to give label to the x-axis, which is income class, and label to y-axis is number of persons. So I'm using this command in R. So this gives subdivided bar chart. Now there is another command which is this one, legend. Legend means this is called legend. So by using this command, you can give legend, and this command is legend locator one. And legend is, we want to give legend as veg and mix, and for veg color is gray color, and for mix the color is white color. So if you copy and paste, means type this in R, I will show. Now, if you on graph, go to graph, and wherever you want this legend, click here or here. I want this legend here, so click here. So this will give this legend. So we will move to our presentation. This is called subdivided bar chart. Multiple bar chart, same data, same example, but we want chart like this. There are vegetarian people shown by this gray color and mixed people shown to this white color. So this is called multiple bar chart. Everything is same up to here, but here only change is bar plot of T of D beside is equal to true. Means this beside is equal to true. By default it takes beside is false, and if you give beside is equal to T, then this will give like this graph. So I will show in this in R. Now this is multiple bar chart, you can see. So you can copy and paste wherever you want. And this is agent locator. Now histogram. The height of 15 students is given and we want to go draw histogram. So already we had entered this height in our software. To draw histogram, just use hist of this height. So go to R. Already we had entered this data, height, H-E-I-G-S-T. And we want to find hist of this height. So this is your histogram of your height. So you can copy and paste wherever you want. You can give some extra arguments also. You can change color. You can change X and Y axis labels. So this is your histogram. Now last chart is your pie chart. The monthly expenditure of a family on different items are given below. This is monthly expenditure. So the family spends 4,500 on food. Like this, 3,500 on travel. Like this, data is given and we want to draw pie chart for this one. So first, enter this data in R. So in X variable, I am entering this data and I am giving names to this X as by using combined function food, clothes, travel, like this. So 4,500 is expenditure for food, 3,000 is for clothes, like this. Data is given, so I am giving names to this X as food, clothes, travel, entertainment, and other. Only use this command, pie of this X. And suppose you want title is pie chart, then use main is equal to pie chart. So use these commands to draw pie chart for this data. I'm typing this in R. Suppose I type this in R, then this will give pie chart for this data. So up to now we had seen how to enter data in our software, how to find mean, median, variance, standard deviation, means summary statistics for given data, how to import Excel file in R, and then correlation, how to find correlation, how to find a regression line, and after this we had seen how to draw charts. Charts are, first one we had seen this by using plot function you can draw a plot, box plot, बार चार्ट, सब डिवाइडेड बार चार्ट, मल्टीपल बार चार्ट, हिस्टोग्राम एंड पाई चार्ट. ओके, थैंक यू वेरी मच.